So we have started with constructors over there. Okay. So it's like actually what there are some newcomers actually what who have joined today. So I'm planning to actually what take a backup session for them this coming Saturday and then Sunday for them. So it'll be morning 7:30 to 9:30, a 2-hour session on this Saturday and Sunday. Okay. In case anyone want to re-attend the sessions over there, you are pleased to come at any point of time. So as usual, this will be our meeting ID. So this will be our meeting ID 3005746 10. Okay, so Saturday and Sunday morning 7:30. Sorry guys, 7:30 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. Sorry, 9:30 a.m. Indian Standard Time. Totally two-hour session I'm going to conduct. I'll be starting from the very beginning. So tomorrow we'll be taking about actually the installation of Java, JDK, Eclipse. And then after that, we'll be starting with the data types and variables. Then we will go on with functions. So that's what. Anyone want to attend for the sessions over there, if you want to re-attend, you can come and join anytime. Okay. Cool. So today, we are going to start with constructors. So yesterday we saw, we are going to give a small recap on the constructor once again. Constructors. Okay. So how a method works? A method will have a return type and then a method will have an argument. So when we need, when we have some set of statements which will be executed multiple times in my program, those things we will keep it in a method. Okay. Then whenever we need those call, we call those methods and then we execute it. That is one. Then the other one is what? Was this R? Yeah, AS came, VatchBD has came over there. So already I have informed over there. So tomorrow and day after tomorrow will be the backup sessions. So today will be just understanding one topic. So tomorrow and day after tomorrow, he will be into the backup session over there. Already I have shared the link also, the same link what he has joined today. So that I will take care of. Okay, Navin. Okay, cool guys. So, Sure, I'll do that. So newcomers are not actually what, once the session is completed, just stay for the last 5 minutes. I will be helping you guys just for tomorrow what, how to do and what we are going to interact a lot. Cool. Okay, sorry guys. So functions level, we will be executing whenever we need it. We call the method and then we execute those set of lines. So there we have return types and then we have arguments. So based on my argument, I need to do some actions. So that time we will be actually what, passing an argument when we are calling the method. Argument means what? It can be an integer or a string or whatever data types are there. We will be passing the values over there. Okay. So that's what, we pass a value to the argument. Based on the argument, it can perform some actions. Same thing, return types. That is, once after executing the method, I want to return some value to my method wherever it's called. Okay. So in Selenium level, simple concept is I want to go to a page, read all the links which is present over there. Then I need to pass the link names over there. That is what one, that is link names. That is a text. So that is string will be the return type for it. So like that, we capture it over there. That is what return types there. Okay. Constructors, what is constructors here means, that is whenever we create an object for a class, that class constructor will be executed. That means, so right now we have created actually what, an object. when we create the object, I'm saying that actually what you will be actually what getting a constructor executed. By default, a memory location for the constructor will be given by the JVM. Okay, so what that will do means, okay, whatever lines we have given over there, that will be executed. Then after that, actually what it comes and comes to the place wherever the object is called. So how a constructor will be written? Always the constructor name will be my class name. The constructor name will be my class name. Got it? As like methods, the constructors also as arguments. So based on the argument type or based on the number of arguments, okay, a constructors can be deferred. Got it? See now. Default constructor. So newcomers, no need to worry. That is actually what all these things actually what they have already, these guys, they have seen for the functions. So it might be easy for them. You guys, no worries. After the Saturday and Sunday sessions, you will be in track with these guys also. So these arguments are the local variables for these constructor, correct? So always local members, if you want to access directly, I need to access them by the variable name. So integer A is a variable over there, which is the argument here. So whenever we call the constructor, we need to actually what pass a value here. Okay, that will be the local variable value for this constructor. Now let me execute this program. Right click, run as Java application. Program starts, program ends. Got it? Program starts, program ends here. So it executes the main function alone, because by default always a main function will be executed. Now I want to call these constructors, correct? Okay, I'll just make an array. So now we have all these constructors. Okay. So now I'm going to call this one. So how to call the constructor? Whenever we create an object, we call the constructors. So now new constructors will help me to create the object. Are we passing any argument here? No. So that means it calls this default constructor. What is a default means? A constructor which does not have an argument. It's called as a default constructor. The same thing in methods. If you don't have any argument for a method, that is called as a default method. That's it. Okay. So here obj1 is the object name, and then the constructors here is what means the class name is a reference here. Load all the global members of this class. Okay. So now you see. program starts, I'm creating an object here, goes and calls me the default constructor. Okay, then after that, actually, again, control comes here, program ends. Okay, if we don't have any constructor in the program, okay, see, in case if I don't have any constructor in the program, by default, JVM will have an empty constructor like this. Okay, that means always a memory will be given for the default constructor. Okay, if you are not giving, by default, actually, what JVM will have a JVM will have an empty constructor. So now we are able to call the default constructor. Correct. Good question. So there is a question from Sangeet. What is the difference between a method and then a constructor? So a method is a set. Whenever I need, I can call them. Okay. Whenever I need, I can call them. But the same thing actually, what constructor, what does that means? Whenever I'm creating an object, only that point of time, I can utilize my actually what constructor over there. Only when I create the object, the constructor will be executed. That's the main thing. Understood?
Yes, Murali.
Good. Still, any questions for anyone? Anyone has any questions so far? Good. Okay. So, constructors actually what will be executed only once in the program whenever we create the object. Okay. So, now how to call the argument constructor? Okay. Can anyone tell me how to call this argument? The same what how we followed in the method level. The same thing we have to do. Can anyone help me? What is the change I need to do and then which place? Anyone can just give it.
In line 19.
Yes.
In the brackets you can give int 8 like 10.
Super. The same thing double. If I want to call integer and double?
A comma and 10.20.
Super. So now let me execute it. Right click, run as Java application. See, integer and double argument constructor. Then it prints me actually what? For the A, what is the value I'm passing? 10. For the B, what is the value I'm passing? 10.20. Got it? Clear for everyone? Everyone understood, guys? So how to call the argument constructors? Any questions for anyone on this?
Yeah, Murali, but for methods, we can't do like this, right?
No. Methods also will have arguments here, right?
Okay.
So, see here.
Can we just call the as we did for the constructors?
No. So, methods, explicitly we used to call the method.
Okay.
OBJ 1 dot method 1. So, method 1 is what? Here we have method which does not have an argument. Here the method is an integer argument, double, integer and double. So, OBJ 1 dot method 1, 40.30, 50. That means the first one is a decimal. The second one is a integer. Okay. So that means goes and calls me double and integer. So double and integer argument method. This will be called for this.
Okay.
Understood, right?
Yeah. Thank you.
Good. Super. Okay. Any questions for anyone so far, guys? Clear? Okay. So now, we'll see how actually what to, if you execute this program, a memory allocation will be given for it. So everything, as we told, it has to be learned as by a memory allocation part. So it's easy for us to understand the basics.
Molly, I have one question.
Yes, please.
So in a method, we are defining the return type, right? String, Boolean, or a void. Are we defining those things in a constructor?
Correct. So good question. Here, in constructors level, we don't have return type. Only in methods, we have return type.
Okay.
Constructors ask only arguments alone.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Super. Okay. So now, as usual, can anyone tell me the beginning alone? What will happen? Okay. Can anyone tell, like to try? So whenever you execute the program, first at the beginning, what will happen?
First, it will create a static memory. Like there will, the main program will be there.
Super. First, a memory will be allocated. So what will be the overall memory name?
Yeah, constructors. Yeah.
Yes.
The class name.
Yeah, class name with some XL decimal number.
Yeah.
Then, what is the first memory which will be created here?
It's a static one. The first memory, it will create the main program.
Super. That is, here it is static pool. Correct. Then what will happen here?
It will contain the main program.
Correct. So that means what are the members will be loaded into the static pool?
Yes. All the static variables, static method, and main program.
Super. Correct. Because main also is a static function only.
Yes.
Okay. That means it loads all my static members. It can be a method or it can be a variable, anything.
Yeah.
So here right now, I'll just type it here directly. PSVM string arguments. Yes. Then next, what level?
They will create the local memory.
Correct. Local memory for what?
Local memory for local variables.
No. Local memory for the?
PSVM.
Correct. The local memory for the public static void main.
That's what I'm calling it.
Super.
Is declared under PSVM.
Yes. Sorry, come again, Dev. I did not understand.
So as we are declaring under PSVM, whatever variable.
Super.
For that, it will create a local memory.
Yes, correct. So right now, here we don't have anything local memories, local variables we're creating. So now it will start to execute the main function. Okay. Yes. So now what will happen?
Now it will create a memory for object.
First execution.
Okay, correct.
So I'm just trying to print program starts. Yes. Then?
There is constructor object one, so it will create a memory for object.
Correct. So new constructors 10.20. So what will happen? This will help me to create an object.
In which the argument, the value of the argument will be stored.
Correct. So what is the object name here it is?
Object one.
So OBJ one. Yes. Then after that actually what is the reference here?
It is integer a double a. So
no, reference. Yes, the class name is the reference over there. So what it will say to the object, load all the global members of the constructors class.
Yes.
It can be static or it can be non-static, a variable or a function or anything. Then my matching constructor, correct? So now, first thing actually what? The matching constructor will take. So what are the matching constructor here? I'm passing an argument.
So it will search as per the argument. Because argument we have one integer, one table.
Super.
So it will check the constructor which has the same argument.
Correct. So it will load the constructor which is matching with that argument, that is this one. Will it load other constructors here?
No, because arguments are different.
Correct. Because based on the argument, only that specific constructor alone will be loaded into this object. Superb. Good one. Then after the text word, along with that, it loads the other thing. So public static void main also is a static. So it loads the main function also inside the object. Okay. Shwet, I'll just tell you about that. When to use methods and when to use constructor. I'll tell you that. Okay, so now we have loaded all the static and non-static members, then my matching constructor. So here we don't have any non-static member, only the static method is the main function alone. Then next, I told you, the constructor will be executed by default, correct? So now actually what, when the constructor is going to execute, it gives a memory for that. Okay, so now what will happen? Constructors integer a comma double b. So a local memory for the constructor, integer a comma double b will be loaded. Then here actually what we have, two local variables for this local memory, that is integer a and then double b. Okay, two arguments here we have. So what we are passing for the integer, it is 10. So n will be loaded to here. Then the double b n.20. Got it? So these are the local variables for this constructor. Correct? Any questions for anyone on this part, guys? Everyone clear on this part? These integer a and double b is the local members of this constructor memory. Okay, then after that executes integer and double argument constructor. Integer and double argument constructor. Then after that prints a. So whenever we add actually what, a string to any information, that will be concatenated, that is joined together. So what is the a value right now? It goes to the, that is whenever we refer only by the variable name, it goes to the local memory. So the local memory for this one is here. Do we have a variable? Yes, the value is 10. Then plus, we are just adding some dashes over there, concatenating it. Then next actually what? B. Go to the local memory, B, that is 10.20. Got it. Next, after that, once we execute this, comes out of the memory. Once we come out of this memory, the memory will be deleted by the garbage collector. Okay, then comes here, program ends. Okay, then after that, control again comes out of the main function over there. So then the main memory is deleted. Then control comes out of the entire memory. So the entire memory will be deleted by whom? By the garbage collector. Understood? Everyone clear, guys? How memory has been allocated and then it's been utilized? Any questions for anyone on this? Can I get a reply from everyone as yes, if you have understood this part so far? Everyone clear?
Murali?
Yes.
Yeah, now we had executed this one, right? If we want to execute next one, in methods, we are only creating one object and everything is executed in that.
Correct.
And in these constructors, if you want, if I want to execute any other, other one. So, yes. So how I...
So now if I want to call actually what the other constructors, how to call? Once again, I need to create the object. Okay. So as of now, I'm having actually what the constructors having these many actually what options over there. So based on our, my program usage, okay, I will be creating an object for that specific constructors. Okay. So usually only one object only will be created. Okay. There only actually what I will define which information to be called. Okay. So every constructor based on that specific argument which I'm passing, so the execution will be present. Okay. So see here right now, if I want to call this integer constructor, once again, I need to create another object. But in real-time scenario, do we create these many objects and then call the different constructors? No. So no. First time only when we are calling the constructor, based on my program usage, actually what we will be calling the specific constructor. Okay. So now if I'm passing only an integer value.
If we want to use that many, it is easy to use methods, right?
Correct. That's what I'm saying, right? So that is objects level actually what? By default, when we create the object, anyway, constructors actually what? A memory will be created for it. Correct?
Mm.
So whenever it's a one-time activity, that time, based for the performance level, it is always good to have it in the constructor because anyway, a memory is going to be created for that. So trying to utilize the same memory which is given for that. Because when you create a method, okay, anyway, a memory is created for the constructor, which is going to be free there. So which is going to be actually what? Simply not used. So method when you do, once again, it's going to create an object. So create a memory for that, then utilize and then do for it.
Okay.
That's why actually what it's better always actually what to keep it in a constructor if it is a one-time activity and then after that utilize them. So there is a question from Jayesh. So constructors are which type? Static or non-static in nature? Constructors are always actually what non-static because why? When we create the object only we are able to use the constructor. There is no option actually what calling them based construct because if it is a static, it will be loaded into the static pool. Got it? Any members which are static, it will be loaded into the static. So this is actually what non-static. Thanks. Can you perform an action inside a constructor? Yes. As like in method, what all we can do, everything can be done in the constructor level also. So you guys actually what right now you're understanding how to use constructor and then the basics. So when you come to the Selenium level, right, there you will be seeing a lot of differences on how to use constructors and everything. Because before going to that, if you understand the basics, these things will be so useful. Because right now, if I say more on the real-time scenario, what will happen? Because you're right now not started with the Selenium, all those things. So I just don't want to confuse you guys. I want to make it actually what in an easier way for you to understand. Then when you come to that sections, so there you will understand in a very detailed way when I show practically. Got it? Any questions for anyone, guys? So far?
Yeah, Murli. In this program, if we want to use the constructor with double array, I'm just saying that we cannot use a constructor with different argument using only one object.
Come again? Constructor?
This object one is array is generated by the constructor integer a and double b, right? So using the same object, can we perform the action constructor double a integer b? Now for that we need to create another object, right?
Good question. So that one actually what when we are executing this constructor, I want to call the another local constructor. Yes, that can be performed using this keyword. So which we will be seeing actually what in the upcoming sessions. Most probably on this coming Wednesday, Tuesday or Wednesday, we will be covering this subject. That is when you call one constructor, a local constructor, you will be calling actually what the another local constructor. Yes, it is possible.
Okay, so we're using one object, we can use multiple constructors.
Correct. You can call other constructors also. So not Wednesday, most probably by the next week. Because first before that, we have to cover the inheritance topic, all those things. So that time it will be easy for you to understand the this keyword, super keyword, all those things. To call local class constructors, to call super class constructors. Those things we will be seeing.
Okay.
Only one question. Sorry, yes. Sorry to interrupt. If the first constructor obj one, okay. I send 10 comma 20, okay.
This one.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So how it will come to know that it has to go to constructor int a double b because it can go to any of that constructor, right?
No. So the thing is new constructors 10 comma 10.20.
No, I'm saying instead of 10.20, it should be 20.
This one also, it should be
20. Yes. Now, the constructor for this is like your int as well as double, and double as well as int.
So right now it's actually throwing an error. So the constructor constructs integer double is ambiguous.
Oh, okay. Got it. But so it will give an error basically. Correct.
20.0. So now actually what is a decimal? So which matches with this constructor.
Okay. Okay.
That's all. So you're saying actually what right now, the 20 also can be loaded into the double variable.
Yes.
So now I will comment this. See now. Okay. So now when I do this, this matches. Because before this also will match, this also will match. Same thing for this also, it will match, correct?
Yeah, that's what.
So that's why it was giving ambiguous error. Ambiguous means that is I have same variety of two things. I don't know to which one to go. That's what ambiguous.
Yeah, got it.
Understood? Good. Any questions for anyone guys so far? Okay, cool. So here we will execute this one step alone. So in case what will happen? Constructors obj2 equal to new constructors of 10. Okay, so new constructors of 10, that means what? It matches with the integer argument constructor. So whenever I load the object, it's going to actually what? Load this constructor's integer a. This also will be loaded into this one, correct? So now what will happen once we execute this constructor? So it's going to create another I need to create a new object for this. Okay. So new constructors of 10. Now what I'm passing over there is an integer value. So it creates a new object here. New object will be created. The object name is obj2. Then after that, actually what? It loads the constructors which is matching. That is constructor of integer a. Then after that, my main function. Then after that, actually what? A local memory for this constructor integer a will be created. So now integer a. So now right now for me, what is the value I'm passing over here in the integer? It is 10. So 10 will be loaded for me here. But then after that, actually what? Integer argument constructor. Integer argument constructor, then a. So what is my a value right now? Here it is. I'm passing. Here is 10. Correct? So it goes to the local variable value. So value is 10. So the 10 will be actually what loaded. Then it will print. Then comes out of the actually what? The constructor memory. Then the garbage collector deletes the memory. Understood this? Then after that comes here, program ends, comes out of the main function, deletes all the memory, everything goes as it is. Okay. Any questions?
So I think it's assuming that it goes to integer A, the first constructors you have. I'm looking at the third one below integer B. So why can't, not that, that one. Yeah, this one here.
Okay.
So why can't the object 2 goes to integer B and calls from that one instead of A?
Good. So right now it has two arguments.
Yeah, because both are integers, right?
So right now here, this constructor, it accepts two arguments. One is double, another one is integer. Correct? So two arguments it accepts. So I am passing here only one argument, that is 10, which is an integer value. So this is the one constructor which has actually what accepting integer value alone. That's why it goes and calls the constructors of integer A. Constructor of integer A. Understood? That answers the question?
Well, but B and A, they are both integers, right?
I know, but both are integers, but the problem here is actually what means, it's like this constructor has two arguments, so double integer. So that means if I want to call this constructor of double A integer A, that is I need to pass here 20.40 comma 10. That is first one double value which matches this, then an integer value which matches this argument.
Okay, yeah, like thank that. You.
Got it? Good. So everyone clear guys so far? Okay, so I'm going to give an assignment. I want everyone to do it right now. So because once you do this, it'll be easy for you. Okay, let it be. Okay, next actually what we will see the other things. Okay, so now we'll have a short break over there. I don't want to continue with the full short over there. No, it's better. I will give some assignment. Otherwise, you guys. Okay, so same program. How the execution will be. I want you guys to execute this program. Okay, so what will be the output for this? So let me. So I want everyone to execute this same program as like how we did this. Take a paper and pen and then do this one. Okay. So I want everyone to do this program for sure, because now itself, if you do, things will be easier for you. Okay. So I'll give a 10 minutes. I'm over there 8:12. So 8:20. Okay. So we'll check over there. So whether you guys are able to do this. Okay. So make sure everyone try now. So take a paper and pen and then you guys try this. Okay, 8:20 we'll again continue. So make sure within 8:20 you complete this. Thanks guys. Hello. Hey guys. So anyone is able to execute the program? Any questions for anyone on this? Everyone tried? Okay, cool. So let me execute it once again. I'll do a fast level. So whenever we execute a program, a memory will be allocated for it. Then the memory name will be my class name with some hexadecimal number. Then after the first memory which will be created, it will be my static pool. All the static members will be loaded. Do we have any static member? No, we have only main function alone. So public static void main. Then it creates a local memory for the public static void main. Local memory for the public static void main. Then the main function starts to execute. So first thing, program starts. Then after that, now I'm creating an object. Okay, so new constructor usage 10.30. That is, I'm passing a double argument. Then the object name is obj1. Reference is my class name constructor usage. Okay, so now it creates me a first object here. That is obj1. Then after that, actually what? Here it loads all the global members, static and non-static. So static members always will be taken from the static pool as it has a single copy. Then the non-static members, if you see over there, we have integer a equal to 10. Then do we have anything else over there? So your new constructor is 10.30. So it's a double. So which accepts a double argument constructor here? Constructor usage double of e. This is the one, correct? So 10.30 we are passing. That comes over here. So now my constructor will start to execute. So for that, a local memory for the constructor usage double e. So for that, it will be created. Double e. So what is the value we are passing over here? It is 10.30. Got it? So then after that, actually what it executes, actually what the constructor, that is double argument constructor. Then after that, my a. So a value will be what right now for me goes to the local memory of the constructor. Do we have a? Yes, that is 10.30. Then again control comes here back to main. It will print. Then next again, one more constructor, new constructor usage 10.30 comma 30. That means what? The first one is a double, the second one is an integer. So now it searches for the constructor which matches. So before that, actually what? It creates an object. Okay, so creates an object here. The object name is actually what? obj2. So as usual, actually, what it loads my main function from the static pool. Then after that, right now here we have integer a equal to 10. Then after that, the matching constructor here I'm passing double an integer. So matches double and then integer. Got it. So then after that, actually what it executes this constructor usage double an integer a. So it creates a memory for that. So what is the double a value and what is the integer b value? So a value I'm passing 10.30, b value I'm passing 30. B zero. Right. Then after the executes over here, integer and double argument constructor. A and then B. So A value is 10.30, B value is 30. Good. Same like that, it continues. Any questions? So then after that, one more thing. Once the execution of constructor has been done, the memory will be deleted. After that, everything is executed, the other memories also will be dealt with. Understood this? Any questions for anyone?
Yeah, Murli?
Yes.
Okay. If in the last object tree, instead in that program, in that method, that constructor usage, it's a default constructor plus one, plus A, then it will take the default value of A, right? 10.
Super. Good. So right now, yes, what you're saying right now here it is, if I have given we will try this also. Okay, this is what we are having, correct? So now, okay, so we are going to create another object, that is obj3. So here I'll just have, I have no space, so I'm going to have here, that's it. So obj3. Okay, here am I passing any argument? No. So it loads actually what this constructor. Okay, before that, my main function and then my default integer a is equal to 10. What type of member it is? It's a non-static member. Okay, then after the constructor usage I'm passing any element? No. Default constructor will be loaded. Okay, then after that, actually what it creates an constructor memory. So here creates a memory for the constructor. So here, any local variable member? No. So from where actually what this memory has been created? From this object over here. Okay, then after that it prints default constructor. Before that, only back to main as well, we forgot to keep that. Okay, default constructor, then plus a. Now I'm coming over here. Do we have a variable in the local memory? No. Can anyone tell me, if we don't have in the local memory, so where the next search will go?
The object tree.
Correct, because this memory has been created from this object tree. Correct? So it first comes here. So do we have anything a variable here? Yes, that is 10. That 10 will be loaded here. Understood? Clear this? A good question. Who asked this question? Nice man. Good. Good one.
Yeah, Murali, one more thing.
Yes.
Yeah. If you are not writing that plus a,
yeah,
we are not passing, then it will just print that text, that string.
Default constructor allow.
Okay.
Yeah. So the thing is, here the information is, we don't have the local memory in the constructor. So from where it takes actually the information is, the search goes next to the object tree.
Okay.
Okay. In the main function, static functions over there, whenever we don't have anything, from there the search goes to static pool. But the, for the same thing for the constructors, the search goes to the object. That's it. Any questions for anyone, guys, on this part? I'll just make it like this. Any questions for anyone so far? Yes.
We just want to try another thing. Let's see. We will create another constructor. This constructor uses a double b or integer b, whatever, integer b, and in system output we put default constructor plus a plus b.
Okay, so plus b when I give, right now do we have any global variables called b here?
No,
so it throws an error.
No, if like you mentioned there in that argument integer b.
Okay, here.
Yeah.
Integer b.
Then we put there plus a plus b in that default constructor. Is that default constructor? In that same function.
So we will take this one.
Yeah. Okay.
So here integer a. So I'll make this one as integer b.
B. Then we'll put integer a. Don't remove that. Don't remove that.
Correct. So here we are going to have plus
b. A plus
a. Plus a. Am I right? This is what?
Yeah.
You yourself can tell you. Can you tell me what will happen now?
I think it will take if we call the constructor, then it will move that to B. First B value will be printed. Okay. Then default value. Right?
Will be printed. Which value? The local.
Local. And then the default value of A, right?
Correct. I think so. Yes, that's it.
But Murali, we don't have any local variable B, right? So what will be the
value? Here the local variable we have made as B.
B, but we have not assigned any value to that, right?
No. So that's all. When you're calling only, you're going to pass some value over there. Right? So in case if I want to call this C, 10, or I'll make it as 100. So now what will be this B value?
Okay, got it. It gets assigned to that B.
100, yes. Got then it. The A value is what?
10. Yeah.
So right click, run as job application. See here, 110. Got it?
Yeah, so I think I just want to know that whether it can differentiate it between the name of the variable instead of A.
Yes. Yes, it should. Okay.
Okay.
Any questions for anyone, guys? Okay, cool. So I'm going to pass you actually what one assignment today. So how to create actually what are the constructors, all those things. So I'll just show you that. I just want you guys to try that assignment so that it will be easy for you. Okay, this one. Okay, Monday we will do this one because it's we have static and non-static information also. So this one we will do it. I'll give it on Monday. Okay. So with this, I'll stop it for today, guys. Actually, what I have forwarded the payment link to everyone. So make sure actually what our demo sessions are completed. So from Monday onwards, actually what we'll be continuing with the paid members. Okay, so before Monday, you guys can make the payment if you have not completed it. So initiate the payment so that we can continue with that. Okay.
I have listened to the classes for yesterday.
I have sent before starting the session. I have sent. If you check the mail, you will be received. Okay. You have received.
I didn't check.
Okay. Yeah, I already sent for yesterday session. Today morning only I sent because I was having some work and it get delayed over there. Okay.
Sure.
Cool. Okay, guys. Thank you. Bye, guys. See you. Bye.